السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن شاء الله to finish the heart. The last thing is the precordium of the heart. Precordium. Okay. Regarding to the precordium of the heart, the pericardium of the heart, peri, like the pleura. If you remember pleura, we're having a visceral pleura, parietal pleura, and the pericardial cavity, the pleural cavity in between, the same. The pericardium, the pericardium yes, the pericardium, it is a fibrocerous sac includes the heart and the roots of the great vessels. A fibrocerous sac, what means by fibrocerous sac? Fibrocerous sac, fibro means fibrous. Yes, yani the pericardium formed from outer layer here, like a sac here, sac, fibrous, F, fibrous layer. And the serous, fibrocerous. What means by fibro? Fibro yani means fibrous. Tab serous. Serous means the serous sac like the pleura. The same structure of the pleura formed from like that. Serous like that. It is two layer. The serous two layer like that here. Two layer like that. This is the serous. This is the serous layer formed from visceral pericardium and parietal pericardium, P. And in between here, you will find the cavity, small cavity, thin film of, which contains thin film of the fluid. And where the heart? This is the heart here, like here. Yeah, but the heart is surrounded by now by three layers. The fibrous layer from outside, then the parietal layer of the serous pericardium, and the visceral layer and the cavity in between. These two layers, visceral and parietal, are continuous to each other here. Continuous to each other because the serous layer is a closed sac. Closed sac. But the fibrous layer, it's surrounding the heart and the great vessels or the origin of the great vessels from above. This is regarding to the layer. So, The fibrous pericardium, it is the outer one, so it's supplied by the same thing of the intercostal vessels and the nerves. Intercostal like the chest wall. So intercostal vessels and the nerves, so this layer is very sensitive to pain, painful. Any inflammation of this layer severe pain, painful. Why? Because it's supplied by somatic nerves. Supplied by somatic nerves, intercostal, somatic nerve. But the visceral layer and the parietal layer or the serous layer, it is direct adherent to the heart. So supplied by the same thing of the heart, like coronaries, artery, and supplied also by the autonomic nervous system. So it is supplied by autonomic. The autonomic nervous system, as we know before, it is involuntary or painless. Painless. Painless, yani no pain. No pain in this, no pain. So the heart, the pain only, if you feel the pain only, means the fibrous layer of the pericardium is affected. This is a pericardium, fibrous serous of the heart. We have two layers, fibrous pericardium and the serous pericardium. And the serous pericardium formed of visceral layer, parietal layer, and pericardial cavity in between. This is regarding to the, this is the cavity. This is a visceral layer. This is a parietal layer, and is outer one fibrous white color. This is a fibrous layer. Okay, The fibrous pericardium of the heart, like a sac, have an apex. Like you enclose the heart inside the sac and you close the heart like henna, yeah, like that. This is a fibrous pericardium, and it is narrow from above. So this is the apex of the this is the apex of the pericardium, fibrous pericardium. Apex means it's a narrow part, yes. Not the apex of the heart here. Here the fibrous pericardium, it's apex up toward the great vessels. Apex surrounding the root of the great vessels. The base means it's the lower part of this sac to the diaphragm, and have anterior surface from the anterior view, and attach it to the sternum by sternopericardial ligament, and have posterior surface from the back related to the posterior mediastinum, and divisive by the pulmonary veins, and the right side, right surface, and the left surface, which is related to the phrenic nerve and the pericardiophrenic vessels. If you remember, any vessels here, any artery, any nerve on each side of the pericardium like that, this is phrenic nerve and the pericardiophrenic vessels. This is in brief regarding to the fibrous pericardium. Anterior side and the apex. Okay. What means by transverse pericardial sinus? Okay. Transverse pericardial sinus, it is a passage, transverse passage. It is a cavity of the pericardial cavity between visceral and the parietal layer. Exactly where? Yes, here. Yes, here. Show transverse pericardial sinus. This is the aorta and the pulmonary. Put your finger behind the ascending aorta and the pulmonary. And in front of the atria, this is the atria. Here, this part here, this is the transverse sinus. It is a narrow cavity or narrow passage between the atria behind and the ascending aorta and the pulmonary trunk anteriorly. Okay, this is named transverse pericardial sinus. Here sinus, not veins. Here sinus means a passage or a space of the pericardial cavity. Where exactly? Lie between what? Between the atria, two atria behind, and the superior vena cava behind, and the two arteries of the, or great arteries anteriorly, like ascending aorta and the pulmonary trunk. This named transverse pericardial sinus. Here, put your finger or your index finger. Oh, this is aorta, ascending aorta. And this is a pulmonary trunk. Put your finger behind it. And push your finger until it reaches to the other side. Now your finger in the transverse pericardial sinus. And your finger now in front of the superior vena cava means the sinus, the superior vena cava behind this sinus. Anterior to your finger now is ascending aorta and the pulmonary trunk. And behind your finger will be atria and the superior vena cava. This is regarding the transverse pericardial sinus. Oblique sinus of the heart or the oblique sinus of the pericardium. But we have now two sinus, one oblique and one transverse. Oblique sinus here, in this, you can find it here also. This is here.
Doctor, in posterior, which is two atria, and a small artery?
No. Yes. No. Which? Two atria, right atria and the left atria.
Atria, right?
Atrium, yes. Atria, it is the plural of the atrium.
Okay.
This is aorta, ascending aorta. Then transverse pericardial sinus. Then here you will see the left atrium. Behind the left atrium, you will find another sinus, is oblique sinus of the heart or oblique sinus of the pericardium. Okay? Ascending aorta pulmonary. Then behind it, you will find the transverse sinus. Then left atrium. Then behind the left atrium, we'll have a small cavity of pericardial. This named the oblique sinus of the pericardium between visceral and the parietal layer. This is a cavity of the of pericardium between visceral and the parietal. But here it named the oblique sinus. Oblique sinus. Okay? You got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
شفتم at the left atrium, behind the left atrium, put your finger between visceral and the parietal layer. Behind the left atrium, now your finger in the oblique sinus of the pericardium on the back of the left atrium. Anterior to this sinus is left atrium, yes. And the posterior, you will find the content of the posterior mediastinum, because the posterior mediastinum behind the heart. And the pulmonary veins on each side, on the left and the right. Is it okay? شفتوا هنا كده في الصورة دي؟ جميلة جدا. هذا الأسندنج أورتا بالمونري. Behind it, this is the transverse sinus. Then the atria, left atria. Behind the left atrium here, you will find the oblique sinus. يبقى oblique sinus here, anterior to it is left atrium. Behind to it is the content of the posterior mediastinum, like descending aorta, esophagus, azygos veins, and so on. But we have two sinuses of the pericardium, one oblique and one transverse. This is the oblique sinus of the pericardium. This is the transverse sinus of the pericardium. Now, you, inshallah, you're having the lecture of radiology later. But mostly I finished. This is the, who can say this part? Anatomy of this part. What is the name? Identify this part.
Knot of aorta.
Yes, aortic knuckle. Type. This is any border of the heart?
The right border. The right marginal.
Right border. And this is the left border. This is the right atrium, okay? This is the left ventricle and the left auricle. This is a diaphragm. Here, this is a diaphragm. Here, you notice what happened to the heart here. شايفين ايه في الهارت هنا؟
Enlarged.
Oh, enlarged. أكتر
مغلوق شوي.
لا, it is more enlarged. أكتر من الايه؟ من الديامترز. لها مقاسات معينة, but it is enlarged regarding to the lung. So it is, بيسموها cardiac tamponade. ممكن نقول على cardiomegaly. But also we having cardiomegaly, يعني كبير, or it is a sign of heart failure. Heart failure is enlarged heart. You know heart failure, inflammation. Pericarditis. What means by pericarditis? Pericarditis. يعني كلمة
inflammation of pericardium.
Inflammation of the pericardium. Of the serous pericardium. So inflammation of this pericardium make fluid, or the pericardial fluid will accumulate excessively or more between the cavity and the weak pericardial fluid, or pericardial effusion, like the lung effusion or pleural effusion before. So it is enlarged like that. What happened? Compression على الاتريا and interfere with the filling of the heart. مش عارف يعمل contraction كويس, فبنسمي الحالة دي cardiac tamponade or tamponade. صح؟ cardiac tamponade معناها ان the fluid outside the heart is more and compressing the heart itself interfere with the filling or contraction of the heart. And how can we deal with this fluid? By inserting a syringe inside this cavity by a certain maneuver. Below the xiphoid of the sternum, and directed the syringe upward till reach the pericardial cavity, so and aspirate this fluid, aspiration of the pericardial fluid. are inserted to the left side of the xiphoid up and backward at the angle 50-45% to the skin to avoid the lung damage. بنسميها paracentesis. يعني كلمة paracentesis here, paracentesis, we have many items of the paracentesis. Paracentesis means removal of the fluid. You can removal of this fluid from the heart, from the pericardium. You can removal the fluid from the lung, from the pleural effusion. You can removal the fluid from the peritoneum, اللي هو peritoneal fluid. All these named the paracentesis. يبقى هنا paracentesis means removal of any fluid from the heart, from the lung, from the abdomen, and so on. The nerve supply of the pericardium. As we said before, the fibrous and the parietal layer of the serous pericardium supplied by the chest wall phrenic nerve, and our C3, 4, and 5, sensitive to pain and painful. And there's a visceral layer which is adherent directly to the heart, supplied by the same supply of the heart, coronaries, and sympathetic supply, and the vagus nerve, autonomic nervous system. It is painless because autonomic nervous system, shabab, autonomic nervous system is painless. Painless. Why the pain of the pericardium referred to the shoulder? Why? بيقول لك ليه ال pain of the pericardium referred anyone having the angina the pain is referred to the left shoulder radiating to the left shoulder why the same nerve supply during embryology okay the same nerve supply during embryology because the heart is developed in the neck then descending to the thorax taking with taking the phrenic nerve لو C3, 4, and 5 with it, okay? Radiating pain to the shoulder, meaning there is an angina. Angina. Arterial supply. The fibrous layer and the parietal layer, the same of the chest wall by descending aorta, musculophrenic, pericardophrenic, intercostal vessels, and so on. The visceral layer supplied by the coronaries. We finished the pericardium. It's easy, shabab.
Easy, doctor.
More clear. You got it. Why I make the pericardium at the last? You got it now or no?
Yes, it's.
عشان نعرف القلب كامل عموماً بعدين نعرف.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, the nerve supply
and everything. And the nerve supply and the arterial supply and the shape of the heart itself. يبقى the pericardium you can study at the last after these lectures. Okay. Thank you very much. إن شاء الله we'll meet later. إن شاء الله الامتحان هيبقى الأحد مبدئياً وإن شاء الله إن شاء الله أعمل confirmation today إن شاء الله.
إن شاء الله.
Thank you, doctor.
شكراً. السلام عليكم.